फिर ले आया दिल मजबूर, क्या कीजे रास ना आया रहना दूर, क्या कीजे दिल कह रहा उसे मुकम्मल कर भी आओ, वो जो अधूरी सी बात बाकी है, वो जो अधूरी सी याद बाकी है, वो जो अधूरी सी याद बाकी है। करते हैं हम आज कबूल, क्या कीजे हो गई थी जो हमसे भूल, क्या कीजे दिल कह रहा उसे मयसर कर भी आओ, वो जो दबी सी आस बाकी है, वो जो दबी सी आंच बाकी है, वो जो दबी सी आंच बाकी है, वो जो दबी सी आंच बाकी है। किस्मत को है ये मंजूर क्या?
As far as the history of Mewar goes, what we could gather and learn is that the first group of the Rajas, that is prior to Bappa Rawal, they had originated from some place in Gujarat near Bhavnagar, and then near, that is Ballavipur, as they call it, Ballavipur. And then slowly they had come here. There were few generations. They were called the Guhilas or the Gehlot dynasty founders. And Bappa Rawal was also a descendant of that family. But unfortunately what happened was that his father Nagaditya was killed by a Bhil tribal revolt. Because it is said that he was very unkind to the Bhil people, unlike the other Rajput Rajas. And so they had all revolted against him. And then what had happened is that the queen had fled with the baby. And then he was sent to somewhere near the Parashar jungle, to some place probably at Anandnagar in Gujarat, near to that. From there he returned back to this place, and then there was a lot of warfare. He was the first person at the point of time. Chittor was being ruled by the Mori group. Now who were this Mori group? The Mori group were descendants of the Maurya clan. So it is said that Bappa Rawal's own maternal uncle was sitting on the throne of Chittor. Finally, the circumstances so happened that he captured Chittor by killing his own maternal uncle. But he did not know the details about his birth, because it is said that Bappa Rawal did not know how to read and write. And many days later, he learned from his queen. He had an amulet. Inside the amulet, there was a small paper where it was written that he was born in the Malaya Mountains, and his father's name was Nagaditya. and then he slowly, and also his mother's name, and then he came to know that he had killed his own mother. He was repentant, and he was a great ruler. He went to rule far and wide, till Kabul, Kandahar, and all these places, and finally he got back to this Nagda, which is very near to Udaipur. And this Nagda has, now it has got no remains of the olden days palace, because I'm talking about a timeline which was around about 8th century AD.